dedicated to your bride, you actually had to go and find a pagan priestess to perform the ceremony for you. It was only in the 1400s the church actually started to perform wedding ceremonies. So a lot of the symbols that you are seeing here today, the swords, the cups, the bells, they've become Christianized, but they're originally borrowed from the pagans. So today, when this couple comes together to take their vows, you will also be asked to take a vow along with them, to aid and assist them in this new love, right, for a year and a day. A pagan hand fasting is a wedding, a witch's wedding, that takes place in three stages. First you have your first stage, which this is, and you take a vow for a year and a day, or as long as love shall last. At the end of that year and a day, should the bride and groom wish to continue, they can then take a second vow for a longer period of time, and eventually a vow for all eternity for all lives. Alright, so today is a first phase, or initial, or the initiating hand fasting. Now, when you perform any pagan ceremony, you always cast a circle. Previous to you all joining us here today, we actually cast what we call an open circle, which means people and spirits can come in and leave. So what we're going to do now is have four attendants actually call the corners for us. So the attendant for the east. Hail and welcome.
I call fire, I call passion, I call love, and I call creation. Come, share with us the joy of meeting new lovers. Bind their love together and make it grow. Welcome, and blessed be.
To be bestowed upon this couple today. Grant them abundance, prosperity, and the bounty of the green earth. So motive be.
Thank you, attendants. Would you like to take your places within the circle? Of the relationship into which you are about to enter. Is there any present among the witnesses, seeing or unseen, who would offer a challenge as to the worthiness of this man and his lady?
I would.
Speak now, everybody silent. Yeah.
The newlywed couple, Teresa and Paul.